Hi everybody, we're going to try a new recipe today, and it is called the Eggplant Garlic Bake, and it's from one of my favorite cookbooks for the slow cooker. Oh, you're probably saying that backwards, that I used to use when I was in the work world. And so I have already sliced my eggplant, and the ingredients call for olives, for onions, for cornstarch, and I've mixed my garlic and mixed onions together, and for salt. And so I'm going to put all of those together now. I'm going to put this garlic, the olives in there, 3/4 cup. Let me get a spatula. And mix all of this together, 3/4 cup of olives, 3/4 cup of chopped onions. You see that's going to be good already. And then I'm going to put in the tahini. Now I really didn't blend this up or buy it or anything. It's just sesame seed oil. And then I put my 2 tablespoons of water in there with it. And then along with that, the basil, teaspoon of basil here. That's going to make it yummy. And the cornstarch, and that's 2 tablespoons of cornstarch. That'll thicken it up nicely. Put that in there. Start mixing that around, and this is what this looks like so far, if you can see it. So I'll just mix that. And it takes a little salt, 1/2 teaspoon of salt. I use sea salt. Doesn't mean that it's better than anything else, but it's flavorful. I think it's natural. And I'm not going to use a lot. I'm going to use 1/2 of what the recipe calls for because I try to cut down on my salt. And then I'm going to put something in there that this person doesn't call for. Since a lot of eggplant recipes use cheese, I'm going to just add some nutritional yeast flakes, maybe something like that, just to give it more of a cheesy flavor. All right, so everything's in there. And this is my slow cooker. And the directions call. I put these in my food processor, so just got some really nice, even slices there. You want them about 1/4 inch thick. So I'm going to spread them across the bottom, make a nice base. And then I'm going to start layering this mixture. Just put 1/2 of it maybe. A little here. A little bit more maybe. And then I'm going to put the rest of it on here. Just like you would layer a lasagna or something. And then I'm going to put the rest of this mixture. By now it looks like this. Whoops, spilled a little on the counter. And I'm going to smooth that all the way down. And I don't know whether I can show you this or not. All right, so it's looking like that. And what I'm going to do is put the last few slices of eggplant on top. And then I've measured out my tomatoes, which is 3/4 cup. Just going to put that all over the top. And then, after doing that, whoops, a lot of noise there. Then I'm going to top it off with a teaspoon of parsley, just for dressing, a half teaspoon actually of parsley. And if you have fresh parsley, that would even be nicer. But this is what I have, and I'll use that. I don't know if my tahini ever got in there. So just in case it did not, I'm just going to add it now. My sesame seeds. So there you go. This is what it looks like now. Isn't that pretty? All right. And so I'm going to put the top on this and plug it up. And then if you're going to work or going shopping, whatever, then this should take maybe 4 hours on slow, or we're going to check back in about 3 hours. We're going to put it on fast, and it's ready. So now I'll get back with you and let you see what it tasted like. Bye.